Hours video. Recently, I was able to go to Chocolate World at Hershey Park in Hershey, Pennsylvania. I was actually visiting my parents who live not too far outside of Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. And it was right after Christmas of 2013, my visit to see them, and we decided to go to Hershey because they were doing some special events and things like that for the holidays, and Hershey, not the Hershey Chocolate Company, but the town of Hershey, was also putting on what they call sweet lights. And they put up a lot of lights. You drive through a state park and they put up a lot of animated Christmas lights, which was really good for the kids. And, you know, I'm not a big fan of that stuff too much. I don't like tours. But this was mainly for, you know, my son, for his enjoyment, of course. And so it was the Chocolate World at Hershey is basically it's you could think of it like Disney World, except it's all about chocolate. Show, like a movie that's for the kids watch. It gets them involved. It's somewhat of an interactive movie. They of course, they have a tour of Chocolate World. They have something new. I'm not sure how recent it was added to Chocolate World, but you can make your own candy bar, which is kind of neat, and I have one here that I can show you. We did that. Of course, they have a dining area where you can get food. All of the Hershey products that you can think of. They have giant size 1 pound Reese's peanut butter cups, which I bought. They have a 5 pound Hershey chocolate bar, which is huge. It's ridiculous, which cost $30. So it's a little expensive. But they see a lot of tourists. You could see there's a lot of people from all over the world there. And so, from what I understand, Hershey chocolate is a little more expensive outside of the United States. You could get Hershey chocolate candy in boxes and however they sell them at the local here in the United States, at the local supermarket, cheaper than you can at Chocolate World. But, of course, you're at Chocolate World, you're going to spend a little bit, you know, so it's a little more pricey, but it's the fun of it, you know. And they also do a chocolate tasting. They have someone that kind of teaches you how to taste chocolate. Professionally, I guess. So I've been thinking about maybe doing a video of a chocolate review. So, well, I have with me a giant crinkly bag full of smaller crinkly bags of some chocolate that we purchased. A little bit pricey. I'm just going to go here and show you some of the different things that Hershey makes that we purchased, that I purchased, and I'm going to sample some of them, and I guess just wing it and talk a little bit, I guess. So, why don't we get started? Of course, I'm going to save the best for last. Hershey is probably one of the most well-known chocolate companies here in the United States, but I'm not sure if they are the best because is the classic milk chocolate Hershey flavor. It's sweet. It's not too sweet. And that cookie wafer is a nice balance so that you could enjoy the whole, all four of the wafers, and it really wouldn't be, it really wouldn't be too much. I've always liked Kit Kat. That's a nice, it's a nice balanced, I think, candy bar. Like I said, it's not too sweet. It's got the cookie. It's a nice little mix there of that cookie wafer, I guess you would say. Not really how you would describe the wafer too much. It's creamy. You can taste the chunks of toffee. The almonds and the milk chocolate is not overpowering. You can taste the toffee too. You can taste all three. So it's nice. It's not too sweet either. So you could definitely enjoy some of those without it becoming too rich and too overpowering. You know how some sweet chocolates can be. Cadbury. What's interesting is I haven't noticed any high fructose corn syrup. I do see sugar invert. I do see corn syrup and invert sugar. Not sure if Hershey products have had high fructose corn syrup in the past and they've totally done away with it, or they never had it. I try to avoid anything that has high fructose corn syrup in it because it's not natural. Soda has it. I don't really drink soda, so I really couldn't tell you if it still has it, but I'm pretty sure it does. But maybe Hershey chocolates never had it. I don't know. But I thought they did at one point. Or maybe certain products do. Maybe I'm completely wrong. It's not that I avoid high fructose corn syrup. It's just full of caramel. So I'm gonna see if I can do this without being too messy. If I can bite into this and kind of show you. You can see it's just filled with caramel. It's coming out, it's alive. Inside is sweet as well, and both of them together really quite sweet. That's more sweet than the other three that I've had so far, and it's always been that way. Caramello has always been a very rich and sweet. I mean, one or two pieces is enough for me, but if you love caramel like I do, it's hard to avoid not eating all that. It's just filled, each little piece, filled with caramel. And was that caramel right there dripping from my chin? Awesome. Alright. This is how we do it. So, let me just check this. chocolate world isn't where they make the candy. It's just like I said, it's kind of like this little it's right next to the Hershey Park, where all the roller coasters and rides are. But like I said, it's mostly just to sell their candy and to show you their processes. But they recently did this create your own candy bar. And what you do, you actually have to put on a hair net. And if you have a beard, a beard net. And I finally have a beard. Sort of. This is the most I've ever grown a beard. And they actually have an assembly line. How they make the chocolate behind some clear plexiglass. But they have so many people going through, you have to, you know, they don't want, it's pretty protected for the most part, but they don't want any, you know, I guess extraneous hairs or whatever flying through. And you actually see your chocolate bar being made. And you get this nice little tin. It's not a typical candy bar. It's pretty wide. I'll show you here. And you actually watch the whole process. You actually pick out the types of filling. The inclusions is what they call it. You can add inside. You can have, I think they call it bittersweet. Or semi-sweet chocolate chips, butterscotch chips, which I added, crushed toffee, crisped rice, and there was something else, I forget. You can choose three of those, and the candy bar is like a tray. They put the little inclusions in that you selected. Inside the inclusions, it goes under a chocolate fountain, and then if you selected sprinkles, it'll drop sprinkles on top. Then it goes further down the line, eventually gets cooled off after about 10 minutes. Then it gets wrapped and everything, and it's not a typical product line because they tell you at the end that the machines would. Take longer than normal, but it's mostly for show. It's pretty neat. So this is the candy bar actually gets packaged right in here like this. It's a pretty cool little box. Sun, you know, for the kid. I couldn't be to my chocolate. Just let me push a button. Okay, chocolate done. Eat. You know, let me watch a movie. I'm just very, you know, I don't know. Anyway, I'm going off on a tangent. So, this is still sealed, but not for long. I want to show you. Itself. Come on. There you go. It's pretty big. It is, does it even say how many ounces? I would say half a pound of chocolate. I would say that's almost a pound. That's a pretty heavy bar. Chocolate. So you can see there's crisped rice in here. I'm going to see if I can split this open. Over the bag without making too much of a mess. Let's see if I can. Not bad. You taste a lot of chocolate. I didn't taste the butterscotch at all. The crisped rice, wow, it's crispy and crunchy. I may have tasted the, I think the semi-sweet chocolate. Chips over and the chocolate and the milk chocolate bar itself overpowered the any butterscotch flavor. There's not too much butterscotch in there anyway to begin with, but here is some of the different, look at that, you can see the different color of the chocolate. This is the Kit Kat and this is the create your own. So it's kind of interesting. It's not too sweet, so I could definitely enjoy most of that. But that's pretty neat to get for the kids, you know, get to watch how a chocolate bar is made right before your eyes. I don't know if you can actually take a tour of the Hershey chocolate facility. I imagine you can to some degree. Chocolate world itself is not, it's a little further away from the actual factories where they make all the chocolate. Alright, so let's get to the two last, my favorite, I guess you could say. I might like coconut better. I know a lot of people is one of her favorites. She loves Almond Joy. And I think that's part of the reason why I love it. So, yeah, I love the mix of coconut and chocolate. It's just out of this world, you know? As soon as you eat that whole piece and bite into the almond just releases all that nutty, I don't know how you describe an almond, and it just mixes so well in your mouth with the coconut, and the chocolate is there. That is one of my favorite. Now, it is a little sweet and on the rich side. So I could only have like two of those. And it's not a candy bar that I eat a lot. It is one of my favorites, but for some reason, coconut is just something that I don't have as often, as much as I love it. For some reason, I don't want to have it as often as I would like, even though I love it so much. I don't understand why. It's kind of like with baklava. That's another dessert that I like. I love that, but I just can't have it that often. Maybe because of how rich it is. I don't know. Okay. The grand finale. Or what? chocolate ice cream, put peanut butter in there. I'm telling you, you won't regret it.
Oh my.